Thinking about building a new home in Erie? Well, that's what this video is for. Let's get started. Hi there, Christy Lee here, and I am a local real estate agent in the state of Colorado, but more importantly, I am a native of Colorado. If you're new to my channel, all of my videos are here to help you figure out where you want to move. If that's something that interests you, please click that subscribe button right there. That way you are notified every time I have a new video. Now, as much as I love making these videos, I love hearing from you more. So there's my contact information. Please reach out to me anytime so we can have a conversation. All right, so I have a lot of people reach out to me all the time and they're more interested in maybe the new build process. So I'm gonna actually cater this video to Erie specifically. I do live in Erie and Erie is booming and there's so many builders out here. And that's probably why a lot of people are gravitating towards this area as well as wanting to build new. But there are things about building new that you definitely need to know. And that's what this video is going to be about. So the first, very, very first thing that I think you need to know is timeline. These builders could be, depending on when you need to move, anywhere between an immediate move or 15 to 18 months out. So we really need to dissect when you need to move, and that's gonna be the biggest factor. So as an example, I've had clients who we've gone under contract and they say, the builder says, hey, you know, this home is going to be ready to move in 9 months. Well, 9 months comes around and it's still nowhere close to be done. Are you okay with that? Are you, you know, flexible and, you know, able to be pushed out, you know, month after month after month, mainly because of shortages of workers or vendors, supplies, whatever it might be. But building is going to be definitely time consuming, and you definitely need to be aware of that before purchasing. Another example that I have is that they were supposed to move in actually in November, and all of a sudden they got pushed back to December and then to January. And there was really, really rushed. And so there was an Airbnb, and there's just so many factors that go into this. So you definitely need to make sure, are you okay and are you flexible enough to have anything and everything happen at the last minute when it comes to building? Now, if you do build if there's a spec home and they absolutely know, hey, this particular home will be available to you to move in on May 15th. That might be a better route because they already are scheduled to have it. They have the permit, they have the CO. They know specifically that this is going to be done at that day. So that might actually be a better route to go. Now, typically the difference between a dirt start and a spec home is simply going to be the customization of the home that you're gonna be allowed to do. So if you do a dirt start, usually the ones that are gonna take anywhere between 8 months to 2 years, technically in their contract, they have up to 2 years to complete these. You will actually get to go to the design center and pick out all of, you know, your customization, pick out your flooring, your lighting, whatever it is, and you're able to design it the way you want. Now, a spec home, the ones that, you know, they know when it's going to be available, they've already pre-planned it, those are already going to be picked out for you. So it's really a matter of, do you like white cabinets? Do you like dark cabinets? And whatever it is in there, you cannot change typically because it's already been ordered. It's already been pre-planned. Construction already knows what's going in. So those are the factors that if you don't like it, you're either gonna have to live with it and change it later or find a different house, different location that's gonna fit more of your needs. So right now it's February 2023 and people are more gravitating towards the new builds mainly because of incentives. So right now builders are, all of the builders are offering some sort of incentive to get you in the door, right? So it's actually sometimes a little bit less expensive to do this than to get an existing home. For instance, a lot of the builders right now are offering either waived, they're paying for your closing costs, or they're coming in with money to buy down your rate. There's a lot of builders out here in Erie that are doing that to bring it down to 4.9 or 5.25. So those are just incentives that are helping buyers come in the door and and, you know, get a better interest rate. Some of them are actually offering like free, you know, finished basements or free upgrades at the design center, whatever. But these are just ways to get the buyer in and obviously build with them. Now, if the same question was asked upon me a year ago, that would have been completely different because there was a wait list to get lots. There was just not enough inventory. But now builders definitely need buyers, and so they're incentivizing everyone to come and build with them. Now, a big factor that you definitely need to keep into play with builders opposed to an existing home is earnest money. So everybody has earnest money, right? That is essentially your deposit to take a house off the market and move forward with the process. Well, builders have the exact same thing, and there are a variety of amounts that you may or may need to pay. So depending on what type of loan, if you use their lender, is going to be a factor as well. But my biggest thing is whether or not it's going to be refundable or not. So that is something you absolutely need to talk to the lender about, or to the lender and the builder about, to be honest. Also, if you're a VA loan, a lot of builders actually will refund it if you need to get out of the contract for whatever reason, but other builders do not. So that is kind of maybe a little bit of a perk to have a VA loan, but definitely figure out, because unlike buying an existing home, there's different processes throughout the contract, different dates and deadlines that you actually still can get your earnest back if you're within those certain dates and deadlines, and you can still get it back. So there's really not as much of a fear if you need to back out for whatever reason. Building is a whole different story. I actually have had somebody lose their earnest money of $10,000 because they just didn't want to move forward with the house anymore. And the builder was very clear, and there was literally nothing that we could do. And so they did lose $10,000. So do make sure you do know up front, which we did, but they decided they wanted to back out. But do know up front how much you're losing, if you're losing anything, if there's any sort of wiggle room, you know, all of those kind of things that you definitely need to know up front. Another huge thing that you absolutely still need to do is inspections. So most people think, well, it's new, I don't need an inspection, everything is brand new and under warranty and yada, 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 which is true, but you still need an inspection. I highly recommend always doing a third party inspection, even if the builder has their own inspectors come in. That $500 that you're going to be spending is worth every penny. I have found so many things wrong within, you know, pre-drywall or even after drywall. A big one is sewer scope. Still get a sewer scope done because underneath you have building debris. Maybe there's a break in the pipe that you don't even know about. And I've actually had that happen. And so if you have an inspection done prior to closing, these are things that the builder has to fix prior, or you don't have to close. I mean, these are factors, but once you close and if you don't have an inspection, then it's like, well, you know, that's pretty much it. So definitely, definitely, definitely always get an actual inspection as well as a sewer scope. Another thing you should think about when building is the lot sizes and the views, and whether or not those views, if you have one or not, is going to be restricted or, you know, blocked at some point in the future. So right now, if you go in and it's like, oh my gosh, this mountain view is amazing, and the salesperson is trying to sell you on this beautiful view, well, if it's open land behind you, obviously it could be built at any time. So make sure you do know what's going on behind that lot, if anything, as well as the lot sizes. I mean, right now, to be perfectly honest, especially in Erie, they're building houses like crazy and they're cramming them in. So if you're somebody who does not want to be on top of your neighbors, you know, maybe you need a larger corner lot, or, you know, something that does back up to something, maybe a park or open space or something like that, because really, in the way that they're putting them in with the fences, usually are going to be like the slat fences. So you really are seeing your neighbors all the time. If that's something that bothers you, either find a different builder who builds it a little bit differently and on larger lots, or maybe a new build is just not the way to go for you, mainly just because, honestly, most of them are going to be smaller lot size, unless you go with maybe a custom builder. Or, you know, or you could like find land that you could build on, something like that. But for the most part, especially in the Erie area, there's only a select few that have a little bit larger for them. But other than that, they're really, really going to be tight. And finally, figure out what kind of community amenities are offered within that community and what the HOAs are. So I will say personally, from coming from experience, I'm in Erie Highlands and we have amazing amenities. We have the pool, the gym, you know, the parks, the school, all of that great stuff. What is a great perk though, is we don't have an HOA, which is very rare in this area, to be perfectly honest, but they are trying to implement that now 10 years later. So that is a bummer, right? You go anywhere else though, some of the other places are gonna have maybe just the pool and like a park, but you're also paying $100 a month, or you're gonna have all of these amenities and it's like $80 a month and you're getting so much more for your money. So do your research, because there's plenty of new builds out here that do offer, you know, or do charge $70 to $100 a month for their HOA fee, but it actually has no amenities. You're paying for trash, you know, trash removal and, you know, common landscaping and things like that, but there's not a pool, there's not a park. And I find that when people are building new, they absolutely want all the newness, but they also want that kind of stuff too. So what are you paying for in your HOA? So definitely do your due diligence on that and figure out which neighborhood is gonna fit best. All right, so those are my tips on building new, especially in the Erie area, just because we are booming out here. I do a lot of new build business, so please reach out to me anytime if you have questions or you need advice or somebody to show you around all these communities. I'd be more than happy to. Remember to click that subscribe button right there. That way you are notified every time I have a new video. And then to the next video, take care.